I'm Guy Lloyd, and this is my telly show. And yours. It's everybody's, because we're all involved. Coming up over the next half an hour, which includes a toilet break, I'll be exploring two subjects that affect our lives. I share my experiences, I get yours, and then in 30 minutes' time, we'll all be a little wiser, having learnt from each other. Or not. It could go either way. In part two, I'll be looking at heroes. In this half, I'm looking at passion. When I say passion, I don't mean any pre-watershed naughty stuff. I mean having a passion for something, which could be pre-watershed naughty stuff, and that would be absolutely fine. I'm very attracted to passion and passionate people. I don't care how mundane or uninteresting your passion is. If I can see the enthusiasm and excitement shine through, I really admire that. It's not what you're really into, it's how you feel about it, what it does for you, and how important it is in your life. Like cake. I like cake, I'm very passionate about it, but I can't eat too much of it, otherwise I wouldn't fit on your screen. Football, there's another one. Music, jogging, comedy, travelling. I've always got too much passion for too many things, so I have to rein it in occasionally. Talking of football, here's Michael.
My passion? Football.
Football, playing or watching?
Both.
Both. Can I ask you your support?
Chelsea.
Get out of here, now, go. Go on. Idiot. Simon believes the children are our future. Teach them well and let them lead the way. Your passion. What gets your passion juices flowing?
Food, friends and education.
Oh! Tell us more!
Well, food. I like my decent food. Friends, people to enjoy it with. And I think children need the best chance they can for a good setup in life.
Okay. Are you a teacher?
I'm a consultant.
Right, okay, so you go around schools, do you? And and what does that day-to-day job involve?
Supporting head teachers to improve outcomes for children in their schools.
And how is it in schools these days? I mean, I've got a boy, he's 12 years old. How is it in schools? Do you think it's improving since our day?
Significantly. Can't believe the... I bet you couldn't probably do the maths tests he has to do to get through. Government still think it's not high enough, but they need the 3 hours to get what they need to get when they get into the... wide world at the end of their school careers.
So what's changed over the last 30, 40 years, you think? Because I didn't like school. I mean, I liked it for messing around. I didn't see much significance in a lot of the subjects. What's changed over the years?
Quality of teaching, hard work of teachers, progress, and just the single-mindedness of the profession to make things better for children.
Here's a hippie. I wonder what hippies like doing.
My passion? Ooh, travelling.
Travelling?
Yes.
Far and wide or closer to home?
I've travelled halfway around the world, spent about 8-9 years in Australia.
Nice.
So, travelled to Thailand, haven't done a lot of it of late, you know, been corner up, but yeah. Other than that, you know, that's what I enjoy, that's my passion, to be quite honest.
And what's been the most interesting country you visited?
Australia. You know, it's a bit like England, but it's a lot drier, it's a lot more amicable, a lot happier,
yeah.
You know what I mean? You know, people are more... I don't know, more alive.
Yeah.
So, yeah, Australia is the one.
And what country would you like to visit next? You got any plans to travel soon?
Maybe India. I want to buy a bus one day. Yeah, maybe live on a bus. Maybe travel to Europe in a bus or something like that.
Sounds amazing. Can I come?
No.
Oh.
Upset. I can see it. Look. Check. All right, you can come.
Thanks. Of course it's travelling. And not combing their hair. Here's a scene from Coronation Street.
My passion.
Sitting outside pubs, having a coffee?
That's it, yeah, exactly.
Thought so.
Exactly, yes.
What about you, Shelley?
My passion. Yes, having a coffee with my friends.
That's fine, that's fair enough. Glad we had this chat. Thanks so much. Thank you very much. You see, drinking coffee, hanging out with a mate and being largely non-responsive can be a passion too. Here's another footy fan who supports a football team I've never heard of.
Football.
Is it?
Mm, it is, yes.
Watching football, yeah?
Yeah.
And who's your team?
Brighton and Hove Albion, or a village team called Nutley.
Nutley?
Yeah, in the Mid-Sussex League, yeah.
Tell us about Nutley. Is that your local team? Is that where you live?
Where I was born.
Okay.
I was born here. I live in Brighton now.
Yeah. And... are they a good team, Nutley, FC?
Well, yeah, they're top of the first division of Mid-Sussex at the moment.
It's not bad, is it?
No, not bad.
And do they get a good crowd?
Maybe 6 or 7, yeah.
Mm. And what's your favourite Nutley football chant?
Nutley football chant? We don't have one.
You haven't got a football chant?
No. It's a village team.
Nutley! Nutley!
No, I ain't got nothing. No, nothing.
No, I don't say no.
Thanks for your time.
How about a game of passion tennis?
Oh, music. Food.
Keep going.
Film. Film. Books. Sunny days.
Keep going. Until the first one pauses.
Oh, David.
Bowie.
Guy Lloyd.
Correct answer.
A lot of people may look at me in this telly show and say, he's got it easy, just walking around with a mic in his hand, chatting to people. But actually, this job can be physically demanding, as you're about to see.
Life.
Life?
Life, yeah, there we go.
Wow. Break that down for us, sir. I wasn't prepared for that answer.
I don't know, just living, really, isn't it? Yeah.
You like living?
Yeah, I like living. It's all right, isn't it?
Just embrace life.
Yeah, yeah, really.
It's good, isn't it?
Yeah, it's good, yeah.
Really good fun.
Yeah, exactly. Exactly.
How about you?
I was going to say Irish dancing.
Wow. You both surprised me with your answers today. Irish dancing, how long have you been doing that for?
13 years.
And how did you get into that? Have you got Irish background?
Yeah, my dad's Irish, but I wanted to do it when I was a little girl, so... You didn't force me into it.
So do you go to classes and sort of do it with other people? Do you perform in public?
Yeah, we go to classes and we perform like on St. Patrick's, like at Molly Malone's down the street and like weddings, stuff like that. So yeah.
Could you give us a little bit?
No. You have to come to Molly Malone's and St. Patrick's and watch me if you want to.
Can I do a little bit?
Yeah.
And then maybe you tell me where how it is.
Right. Right, first of all, you need to turn your feet out, like that. Right. No, cross over like this.
Oh, like this?
Yeah, no, this foot has to be out. And then you have to do that with all your feet turned out, basically, what you just did.
Like that?
Yeah, but yeah, that's so much better. Well done. Well done, that's much better.
I think I pulled a hammy.
That'll be the last time I try Irish dancing. I'm more of a freestyler myself. Here's Chris.
My passion? Get out and about and do things.
I can see that on a bike.
This isn't a bike, this is a shopping trolley.
What is the plan today, sir?
Checking out snowboard bits and pieces and sorting out my camper for going away for a month in Scotland.
This sounds amazing. You snowboard, do you?
Yeah.
And whereabouts are you going in Scotland?
Glenshee.
Okay, is that a regular haunt?
We were there 2 years ago for a couple of months and had a fantastic time, so we're going back again.
And how long have you been snowboarding?
About 10 years.
How did you get into that?
Gave up skiing and jumped onto snowboards.
Right. Why is that? Skiing scares me. I've tried skiing, didn't like it. Snowboarding looks a bit more safer.
It's a buzz. Yeah. It's a real buzz, yeah.
And enjoy!
A lot easier to carry a snowboard than it is the skis.
Yeah. This is Jordan. Jordan knows what he likes.
Food.
Food!
Yeah.
It's a good one. Why not? Nobody said that yet. What is it about food that you love?
I don't know, it's pretty much comfort food, isn't it?
It's just great, isn't it? What's your favourite food?
Pizza, all day long.
Pizza?
Yeah.
How many pizzas would you eat over a week on average?
Over a week, it's pretty bad for you because of the dough, but I'd probably just have to say two.
Two pizzas a week?
Yeah, I could eat more. I could eat it every day if I could live on it.
Yeah. You're just reining it in, aren't you?
Yeah.
And here's Loopy Lou.
My passion is working and helping and working with children. And helping people and walking doggies and looking after doggies. And I'm a children's entertainer, so I love, and I like going to other countries and helping children there as well.
So you like caring and you like entertaining?
That's me, yes.
And that's your job?
That's my job, and I do children's disco parties, and we all have an amazing time.
Available for children's parties, and that's it. Here's a man.
My family first, I suppose, and then... Fishing, my boat, yeah.
That's the first time someone has said family. It's good to hear.
Thank you, yeah.
What a role model of a dad you are.
Oh, I know, perfect.
And when you can get away from the family, you like a bit of fishing, do you?
Yeah. I've moved to New Zealand and got a little boat there and, yeah, it's all good.
You've moved to New Zealand?
Yeah, married a Kiwi.
Amazing.
Yeah, just back over here for my family, going back Friday, yeah.
What does fishing give you?
It just shuts off from the modern life, doesn't it? You just get away, you can't see nothing, just you and the sea and hopefully a dinner afterwards.
Here's Paul. Paul's having trouble getting his head around the word passion.
What gets, you know, your passionate juices
what
flowing?
What gets me annoyed?
No, what's your passion? What are you passionate about? Come on, show me some passion.
Well, I love my jet ski and my boat.
There you go.
I'm very passionate about those.
How often do you get out on that?
Well, when the weather's permitting, living in this country.
I do love humans. That was just a quick cross-section of the human race with all their passions. It's so important to have a passion. Something that gets you excited, something to look forward to, something that takes you away from the less exciting things in life. And when you get passionate, that can inspire the people around you because it's infectious, like a verruca. And in life, it's good to have a role model. Someone you really admire and perhaps look up to, unless it's Ronnie Corbett. That might be tricky. When I think about my heroes, I have quite a few for all kinds of reasons. I'm like Avengers Assembly. My ultimate hero would be Freddie Mercury. He was an amazing performer and by all accounts a lovely man. He's just brought a lot of joy to my life from a very early age. But then so has my family, who've had a huge influence on my life. And then I start thinking about people like Mandela, Muhammad Ali, John Lennon. The list goes on, but I take different traits from different people and soak them up for myself, with the aim of becoming some weird crossbreed of all of them. Anyway, enough of my yapping. Here's some people talking about a great man we lost recently.
Well, it's got to be David Bowie in it today.
Are you feeling that?
Yeah, definitely, yeah.
Is that someone you grew up with musically?
Yeah, definitely, yeah. I suppose first exposed to him in like Ashes to Ashes period and loved it like when I was young in the 80s. But then because you love it, you sort of go back to his back catalogue and it's all great.
So, still sounds amazing, doesn't it?
Yeah, definitely.
How did you feel when the news came through?
Shocked, really shocked. Because obviously no one really knew, did they, that he'd been ill and stuff like that. It was just, he's got a new album out, it's his birthday. Will he tour this time? Let's hope so. And then, yeah, the sad news.
It is sad. What about you? Who's your hero?
I would say David Bowie, but it's not. It's Freddie Mercury. I left
it. You two, honestly, my two heroes are Freddie Mercury, number one, and then Bowie just below. Tell us about Freddie. Tell us about your love of Freddie. When did you first come across Freddie?
Years ago when I was a kid, growing up, always used to listen to just the greatest hits. You know, you get them as a present. I used to get them, just listen to it constantly again and again, and then grew up learning more about their music. Great.
Did you ever get to see Queen?
No, obviously not. A bit young. Sorry.
Did you ever get to see Bowie?
I didn't, no. No.
You see, that's sad, isn't it? You never get to see these guys.
We were talking about it, wasn't we, recently, like... We had tickets for Michael Jackson and then obviously that didn't happen. Yeah. We got tickets for Janet Jackson, now she's ill. We're trying to, you know, like ticking off people that maybe not heroes, but just people that wouldn't it be great to see? Mm. And then it was like, who, you know, David Bowie, he's got a tour, please let him tour, you know.
I saw in the recent years, I've seen The Who and Rolling Stones, luckily, at Glastonbury for that very reason. Yeah. Just because you think, well, you never know when they're going to pop off, do you?
Well, that's true. Yeah. I mean, you've seen The Stones, haven't you?
I've seen The Stones and The Who. Yeah, love all that old music. Yeah. Excellent.
And here's lovely Leslie.
Who was my hero?
Yeah.
David Bowie.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
Oh. How did you feel when the news came through?
Very sad. I think we all did, didn't we? Yeah.
When did you first get into David Bowie?
Oh, when I was about 25, a long time ago.
Did you ever get to see him live?
Yes.
Tell me about it. Where was it?
It was in London somewhere. I can't remember which venue. It's a long time ago. It was a Spider's Web tour or something like that. So I did see him live, yes.
And how was he?
Marvellous. Yes.
I'm very jealous.
Are you?
I never got to see him.
No, a lot of people didn't.
That makes me sad.
Well, I did, so there we are. Okay, that's enough.
That's fine.
Anything else you'd like to ask?
No, that's fine. Oh, what's your name?
Leslie.
Lovely to meet you, Leslie. Have a great day.
Yasmin's like me. She's got a whole bunch of heroes.
Hero, growing up, I was very into Bono, David Bowie, obviously with the tragic death. No one else, particularly my mother.
And your mum?
My mum, my dear old mum.
Tell us about your mum, what are her qualities?
She's kind, generous, huge heart, spoils me rotten. I'm 42 and she's still buying me things. So she's great.
Here's mummy's boy, Harrison.
My hero? Mum.
Mum. Yeah. Oh, tell us about your mum.
Just all round incredibly, incredible woman.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And at what point did you sort of appreciate that, acknowledge that? Because we go through different periods with our parents, don't we?
From quite a young age. Mm. Yeah. Yeah, quite a young age.
What would you like to say to your mum? Say it down the camera.
Thank you. You wonderful human being. Love you lots. See you on Friday.
See you Friday.
Cammy, it seems, has an ulterior motive for her hero worship.
My dad.
Oh, why your dad?
He gets me out of trouble.
Does he? Are you in trouble a lot?
No, like money trouble.
Oh, financial trouble.
Yeah.
So if you need like a bit of cash, you can just call on your dad and he'll deliver, will he?
Kind of, yeah.
Do you live together still?
No.
So you've moved out?
Yeah.
But you're still relying on him financially?
Yeah. Which is quite bad.
Need to move on from that, don't you?
Yeah, I'm a student, so.
Oh, okay. Well, that's fair enough. It's hard being a student, isn't it?
Yeah, it is.
And we sort of, when you negotiate with your dad, do you go in high and then perhaps end up taking a lower sum, or does he just give you the high sum?
I just ask straight up.
And he'll give you what you demand?
Yeah.
She's a tough negotiator, this one.
Here's a thespian.
Ben Kingsley.
Ben Kingsley, really? Yeah. That's an unusual one. So where does that come from? Why do you admire Ben? Sir Ben, isn't it?
Sir Ben, yeah, God. Sorry, Ben. Yeah, no, I'm an actor, so I've always admired him from a young age. Yeah.
And favourite role, Ben Kingsley's?
Gandhi, it's got to be, isn't it? Classic.
And how's your acting going?
Yeah, it's fine.
Where can we see you? Can we see you on the telly, a film, anything coming out of theatre?
ITV, Beowulf, BBC Father Brown, on at the moment, Sunday nights, midweek, Monday to Friday. And something I can't tell you about, but it's, you know, exciting.
Ooh, what's your full name?
My full name's Alex Price.
Alex Price. Google Alex Price and watch his star rise.
Don't. You'll just get lots of naked pictures of me and Penny Dreadful.
Here's a group of thespian known as Thespians.
Chris Pratt.
Chris Pratt?
Yeah.
Who he?
Who is he? An actor.
Oh, yeah, I know him. Is he like a superhero film?
Guardians of the Galaxy.
That's right, yes, I know the guy. Who's your hero?
I'd probably say Christopher Lee.
Really? As in Dracula?
Yeah, yeah.
Old school?
Yeah, I mean, we're film students, so okay. We watch all that sort of stuff.
Oh, I see. He's no longer with us, is he, Chris?
Yeah, I would have loved to have met him. Yeah. But.
And who's your hero?
Mandela.
Mandela.
Yeah.
That's the first time we've had that today, and it's way overdue.
Yeah, I just see him as a real true inspiration to just go and do things you want to do and just respect everyone as they are.
Here's the original hoodie. The king to reign over all hoodies. Lord Hood of Hoodie. It's Steve?
Who's my hero? The guys in the military.
Really?
Yeah, I just see two of them down the gym. They're not, they're the heroes, man. They really are. They, just phenomenal. I just spoke to a couple of them down the gym that had just come back from Afghanistan and just, you know, you see all these big guys lifting all these big weights and then you see two little guys in there from the army and they just, the statue of them is far bigger than any big guy down
different
there.
Different league, isn't it?
It is. And they're just, you know, I like to listen to the stories that they tell because it's all part of history, you know? You have to listen to that stuff and then you pass it on to others.
Yeah.
You know?
And I guess if you agree with war or not, it still doesn't take away their bravery, does it?
I'm ex-military and I don't agree with war, but I know what they've been through, you know? Yeah. And it's just, it's amazing. They are. I mean, the two guys that are down the gym this morning, both of them injured, one of them missing part of his arm, another one really mentally challenged from PTS, and just going about everyday life. And they don't, you know, there's no moaning or groaning there. Yeah. This one, they're happier than most people in that gym in the morning, you know.
Yeah.
Thanks, Dave. Here's Elise.
Jesus.
Oh, no. Oh, Jesus. So I thought you were just saying Jesus. Actual Jesus.
Yes, actual Jesus.
Tell us about him. Why is he your hero?
Because he was humble. Because he was kind. Because he loved unconditionally.
He liked a beard as well, didn't he?
Yeah, and he looked cool.
Jesus is cool.
This is Eric. I love Eric.
I haven't got a clue.
Not a clue?
No. I've got no heroes.
No heroes at all?
No.
Do you want one?
No.
No. I can offer you one.
No, I don't want
pretty
one.
Cheap.
No, I'm on my home now.
All right.
All the best to you both. Bye.
Eric has just become my new hero. Charlotte, meanwhile, is still looking for one.
I don't know.
You're not got a hero?
No, not really.
I could be a hero.
Okay, you can be my hero.
Is that right?
Mm-hmm.
Do I look like a hero?
I don't know.
Well, we covered a lot of heroes there, each and every one of them deserving a mention. And I found a new hero in Eric. But the best thing we can do from here is to become a hero to someone else. Make other people look up to you as a source of inspiration by being a good human and doing good human things. As always, feel free to post comments or a photo of your cat on my Facebook page, Guy Lloyd's Telly Show, and you can also tweet me at @Guy_Lloyd. Thanks for watching, and I'll be back next week with more stuff and things.